If you've got a heart condition or any of these other preconditions, you have been prescribed a blood thinner or blood pressure medication, whether you're going for vaccination or if you've got COVID or you're recovering from COVID, you need to continue those medications. Is that what you're saying?
Absolutely correct. Please continue. Everybody has to continue their medications, the blood pressure medications, the heart medications, and the blood thinning medications. Everything has to continue the full dose, and they are absolutely safe to take vaccination because vaccination is the very, very important thing, which is against the fight against COVID, can only be won if we have more vaccinations.
Somebody is asking, Rajat is asking, he has not been on blood thinners till now. He said, I've not been on blood thinners till now or any of those medications, but I've been told that there's a risk of coagulation. So should I start blood thinners now? I am recovering from COVID. 10 days have passed since I had COVID. I'm recovering. Should I start having blood thinners?
Okay, so now this is also a very, very important thing which has been identified as one of the complications of COVID, that blood thickening happens and leads to clot formation inside the lungs, inside the heart. So to prevent that, some people, not every COVID patient has to take it. All those patients who have moderate or severe disease, these patients have to be on anticoagulation, which is the blood thinning tablets or injections. If they are hospitalized, they will be put on injections, and then follow up, they will be given blood thinning tablets for the next 1 month or so. So that is a usual medication plan which we give for prevention of blood clotting in patients who are having moderate to severe disease. But a word of caution here, that as you were already discussing, that people should not start taking these medications on their own. If it was a mild disease, if everything is, if all the factors of, the blood tests, the CT scan, if it was done, or the symptoms, if everything was in the mild to or even a moderate category, it's not necessary, because if he is not a high-risk person. If those
Okay.
patients who are high risk, those patients who had severe disease, who were hospitalized, then these patients definitely need to take blood thinners.
Warning
Sure.
signals to look at. What should you be doing? How do you change the management of COVID if you're a diabetic?
So I think the prevention strategies are the same. So there's no confusion. People ask, what should I do specifically if I'm a diabetic? So that's not different from anybody else. You have to do it even more stringently, but nothing else. And before we go ahead again, I think it's important the number of calls that Praveen gets about getting vaccination. The same thing here. Diabetes is not a contraindication to vaccination. In fact, the vaccine was developed for people with diabetes and heart disease because they are the ones who really require protection. And uncontrolled or controlled diabetes or whatever medication you are taking will not come in the way of your getting vaccinated. So that's out of the way. So our study clearly again showed that baseline HbA1c, which is a measure of baseline glucose control, correlates with the outcomes of COVID infection. So well-controlled diabetic. So if you're a well-controlled diabetic, generally healthy, looking after yourself, there is really not much reason to worry at all. So I think that's an important point. So sometimes during lockdowns, last year this happened a lot, people stopped testing. They just gave up on their diabetes completely. And suddenly when they got COVID, then they sort of panicked and wondered what to do. The symptoms and signs are similar, but as Avi and Praveen said, that basically our threshold for action is lower. So we will quickly sort of intervene in such patients as compared to someone who has completely normal blood sugar. The other important part is that sometimes people feel very depressed about this, that I've got diabetes and I'm going to get into trouble. Control during the infection is also very important. And we have found that those who are well controlled when they are down with COVID, well controlled diabetics, those people who are keep their glucose well controlled have much better outcomes than those whose sugars are all over the place. And as I said, and I will repeat, sugars tend to go really high. The number of 500 and 600 milligram sugars I have seen over the last 1 year, I have not seen those in a lifetime.